Hey everyone, Austin here with The Real Seal, back again for another blog video to talk to you about bowing walls. Your foundation wall starts to either bow in or crack at the middle and start to bend inwards, or it'll start to tilt over as if it has lost its connection at the top of that foundation wall. Now there are four main causes. The first one is expansive soil. Expanding clay soils, especially in Chicagoland, that once they get wet, they expand, which pushes that wall inward. The second main reason we have is hydrostatic pressure. Hydrostatic pressure is very simply the water building up outside of your home. This hydrostatic pressure will push against the wall and cause that foundation wall to bow inwards. Next up is frost heaving. Frost heaving happens in much the same way as expansive soil happens. Frozen weather, the soil will expand, especially if it's wet. And that expansion will cause the pressure to push on the wall. This is especially prevalent in shallower foundations or when we get those super, super cold polar vortexes that have been coming through lately. For our fourth cause is lateral pressure. Lateral pressure can be a number of things. A big cement truck driving next to a wall that was newly poured, and the pressure of that cement truck pushing on the wall pushes that dirt inwards and causes it to crack and bow. If you have grading that goes way up this way, the soil will want to creep towards the house and it can cause this excess pressure on that wall. We have a few different solutions that we like to use when we're dealing with these bowing walls. The first and our favorite is, as always, carbon fiber. It straps on the wall at certain intervals, stop and arrest that movement of that bowing foundation wall. These diagonal cracks are a big sign that you have a bowing wall happening, even if you can't really see the major movement yet. Carbon fiber is best used when the bow or tip is under 3 inches. As long as it's under 3 inches of movement, we're able to stop it with a lifetime warranty, even up to the point where we'll replace that wall if that carbon fiber fails. It is the most effective solution, and if you catch your problem early, it is the most economic as well. Wall pushback is what happens when we get a wall that's bowed more than 4 inches, and now we have to get that wall back up to as close to plumb as possible. Wall plates. What this essentially is it's a steel plate that sits on the inside of your wall, and then we have another steel plate that sits out in your yard. There's a long threaded rod that connects them, and we will dig out a trench on the outside of the wall to allow that foundation wall to move backwards, and then we literally pull that wall back using the pressure between the plates. Sheared walls, we can use carbon fiber if it's still under 3 inches, but if not, we'll move over to C-channels, which is essentially the same thing as wall plates, but the C-channels have a steel I-beam that goes the whole length of the wall so we can grab that entire wall. We also use this in cases of cinder block foundations because those mortar joints aren't that strong. This C channel goes the whole length of the wall, and it's again connected to another plate that's the same as the wall plate out in the yard and connected with a threaded rod. We will dig outside to allow the wall space to move, and then we will pull that wall back against the C channel and the plate. And with every one of the ones that we do, if it's a poured foundation wall, we will do epoxy injection as well in order to stop water from seeping into your basement. Now, if there's a cinder block wall, we can't do epoxy injection. In that case, we'll have to do a wall covering with a drain tile in order to capture that water. Because of the hollowness and the mortar joints of the cinder blocks, you cannot use epoxy injection or even polyurethane injection to fix it. The wall plates and the C channels both come with 25-year warranties, and the epoxy ejection lifetime warranty. We have how we do it videos on carbon fiber, wall pushbacks, epoxy injection, and we can show you in person on a live project how we fix these walls so that you can see what you're getting into and what it's going to look like when it's done. If you have any questions at all, give us a call at The Real Seal. Not everything's better when wet.